you're on the fence about this motorcycle, or if you've already discounted it, or even if you've ordered one and have one, there's something in this video for every one of you. This video is sponsored by Bikesure Motorcycle Insurance, who not only insure standard motorcycles like this BSA, for instance, but they also insure weird, wonderful, and wacky motorbikes. So if you've got one of those sort of bikes, get on the phone or go onto the website and get yourself a quotation. I'm going to give you my thoughts and impressions on the BSA Goldstar 650. My first impression of this bike when I got on and rode it was that at very slow speeds, it's remarkably good. Now, you won't often hear that in a review. Most people bang on about how good it is when you're revving the nuts off of it at the top end. But I had to ride it down a steep, slippery road with lots of wet leaves on it. And it's remarkably good at tick over, just chugging along. And that's really important. So if you're in traffic, and if you're in the countryside, and if you're going down difficult roads, or even if you're maneuvering it in the garage or in the yard, being able to ride at slow speeds at tick over is very important. And this bike does it probably better than anything else I've ever ridden. Another thing you notice when you get onto this bike is how everything seems to be in the right place. So straight away, you can get on and ride it without having to work out how this works, how that works, where things are, where the pedals are. You just sit on it and it's there in the right position, which is great. I've ridden this bike quite a lot in the last couple of days, and I must say I do love this engine. It's very happy at lower RPM, and it's got lots of grunt and torque at the lower RPM. But when I looked at the rev counter saying low RPM, below 2000 RPM, it doesn't like it, it struggles. Whereas on a Harley or a BMW R18, if you open the throttle up at 1700 RPM, it'll pull like a train. This doesn't really get going till about 2250 RPM. And from that to about 4,500 RPM, it's at its happiest. So you want to ride it in its torque band to get the most out of the bike, and it feels much more classic in that rev range. Yes, you can rev it higher than that and it will perform nicely. And a little bit of vibration at high RPM, nothing to worry about, nothing to speak of. It's a single cylinder, but that gives it a lot of character. But yes, it's a much happier engine burbling along than it is thrashing it like a sports bike. The clutch is light, the gearbox is very slick, the brakes are good, the suspension gives you lots of feedback from the road surface. And that's a good thing. I wouldn't call it harsh, I would just call it communicative. And that gives you a really nice involving ride. The exhaust note is nice. With the right pipe, it would be fantastic. You've got a catalytic converter just under the radiator, and all that gubbins just does destroy the character of bikes these days. But you've, of course, can illegally swap that out. I wouldn't recommend that, of course, but I'd do it. But that would give the bike much more character and much more sound. I do love the look of these classic mudguards. They're very beautiful. But I was a little bit surprised at how much muck is on the bike. And I think some of that's come from this little indentation there. And it would benefit from a little flap underneath there to stop some of the mud and road muck coming onto the lower part of the bike. And around here, again, it's a bit mucky, but not on the back here. So you would expect that from a dirty ride. None of your smutty thoughts here. I'm just talking about the road surface. styling wise, overall I do like the look of the engine, but when you look closely, this sort of cover here and here and here and here could have been made a little bit nicer. If you look at the cover here on the Norton, it's beautiful. So if this was a cast part in a nice shiny metal, little things like that would just bring the bike up to another level, and maybe there'll be some aftermarket parts made for it to do that. But that's what would have been nicer, just to sort of raise the bar a little bit on the styling. The same goes for this side with this cover here. Again, if it was a cast part, a nice, shiny, beautiful metal, it would look so much nicer. I'm not saying it's terrible, but these little touches would make it look a little bit more classic than it is. Aside from that, I do love the overall styling of this bike. It does look very classic. I love this petrol tank here, and some of the paint schemes that you can get on this are absolutely gorgeous. And I do love this one here too. This chrome bit on the side is lovely. And the tank, not only is it a nice shape and it's made of metal, but it's a really good shape to squeeze with your knees when you're giving it a bit of throttle. I love this seat as well. I love bench seats. It's very comfortable. It looks very classic. You can move forwards and backwards on it, which is good, so you can change your comfort or your riding position depending on what you're doing. I'm 6'2" and 6'3" in high heels, and the riding position is absolutely lovely. My arms are stretched out. There's plenty of space. My legs are not too bent, so I don't feel cramped up, and that's great. So it's a comfortable bike, and it's a bike you'd spend all day on if you wanted to, or just go out for a short ride. Either way, it does it very nicely. I really love the classic round headlight, and I love these fork covers here. That's really nice. And these instruments here are beautiful. I love the way it goes round on the bottom rather than on the top. Something a bit different, why not? You've got a little thing here which is sort of in smoked glass. So if you've got a smoked helmet, actually it's quite hard to see what it says, so I'm going to take my smoked visor off and put the clear one on, to be honest. But I love these. It's like a nice analog watch. It's a beautiful thing to have in this digital age where everyone's going for TFT screens, which I can't bear. This is a nice change, and this is why I like the classic bikes, because they're beautiful as well as functional. This little USB thing you've got here in a flappy up box, USB, I think it's USB-C as well they call it. That's really good to have. And I think what they've done here is try to match the brake thingy from the other side so it kind of balances the bike. That's why they put it there and in that shape. And you've also got this little socket down here. I can't remember what they call them, but it's like the cigarette lighter, but a bit smaller, which they use on motorbikes. Same on my BMW. So that's good for accessories and things as well. The tyres it comes with, Pirelli Scorpions, I think they are, if I can read it correctly. They're good in the dry. In the wet and in sort of lanes where you've got a bit of slippery stuff on top, they're not the best for that. You could get something with a little bit more tread in it, but I'd say for dry tyres they're good. And it all depends where you ride, of course, so you can change the tyres to suit your needs. So, as the new kid on the block, if you like, who'd thought I'd say that about a BSA, of the modern classic motorcycles, this certainly gets my vote. It's very good indeed. Have a look at the review that Darcy did, if you've not seen our channel before, we're called Mr. Darcy and the Old Man. I'm the Old Man. Darcy is my son. He reviewed this bike and he loved it. He's 20 and he thought it was fantastic. As a 20-year-old, you'd expect him to be riding a pointy plastic piece of rubbish, which he doesn't like at all. He would much prefer one of these. So there's something to be said for that. And he also did a comparison between this and the Royal Enfield Interceptor, so watch that video as well. So big thumbs up from me, very nice bike. I would get one of these. So you might want to get one because they're very good.